Okay, Google, call Vietnam Airlines customer service.
Sorry, who do you want to call?
Vietnam Airlines customer service.
Who do you want to call?
Vietnam Airlines customer service.
Who do you want to call?
Ghostbusters.
Ghostbusters by Ray Parker Jr. Sure, playing on Spotify.
Okay, Google, turn it up. Maximum volume. All right, Dream Big Kid here. Angelo, bam. Check this out about airline travel in Vietnam. Today is the Saturday here, Memorial Weekend. Today is what day? The 20 what?
29th.
And we're hopping on a Vietnamese app and looking at airfare. In Asia, they don't have that crap the U.S. sells you, but you must buy 14 days advance or you get, you know, raped. Check these out, these prices. This is from Ho Chi Minh to Dalat. It's not that far. It's only about a one-hour flight. It's 170,000 VND. 230,000 VND is $10. So that's like $7. Now, that's not including the airport fee. The airport fee is about how much? Oh, really?
No.
Is that for all of us?
For all of us.
Oh, okay. She's chewing. 2.5 million for three people. $30 in fees, but the ticket is less than $10. High five. We're going. So also when you shop for airfare online, there's ways to search Google Maps. There's a way to do it incognito, because even when you take your U.S. phone over to Asia and you open up your Travelocity or your Expedia, they know you are still part of an American market and you will still pay American prices. So her and I did it before where I searched these same flights, these same airlines, same flight numbers. And pardon me, I was eating a cracker right before I started this. And we were going to pay like, I was going to pay like $150 more than her per ticket, because it knows Vietnamese won't pay that. Good times. So we're buying it on her app because my phone's still set to the U.S. Good times. It is Saturday, the 29th, Labor Memorial. And this door is still not closing all the way. All you got to do is pull it open. So that's Vinh Hom's. Oops. And if you pull it too hard, yeah, it pins itself open. That's Vinh Hom's Golden River for you. Nice and not secure. Cannot wait to move out of here. Actually, on my way to Dalat to look at our new place. See, didn't lock that time either. Absolute joke. I reported this door 2 weeks ago. Don't ever live in Vinh Hom's Golden River. All right, I am having bumba at our little place near Mama's house. This is what it looks like. Good bumba. You grew it. Love it. Nice coloring. Nice coloring means nice flavor. So, looking forward to this. You know, you put your spoon under there, you can't even see it. That's going to be some good flavor. I always say if you can put your spoon halfway down and still see it, it's going to look like water, it's going to taste like water. So this is going to be good. Yum, yum, yum. Got my lime here. Mm-mm-mm. But I usually taste it before I put lime. And I came here without any cash, so Fung is on her way here to save me. The plan for today is we're heading to Dalat to look for a new house. Tired Ho Chi Minh, I cannot breathe. I've been having sinus infections, sore nose, everything, like horrible, horrible breathing problems in Ho Chi Minh. Right now it's not too bad because it's going into their fourth lockdown. It's going to be 6 weeks and it started yesterday, so really bad. No gatherings of more than 10 people. I saw another post that said buses and public transportation are supposed to have no more than 50% occupancy. Taxis are supposed to have the windows down, no air conditioning. Like, right now I don't see a lot of the cars following that rule, and including the one that we used to get here to Mama's house today. But there's this like health check. There's this, when you get a Grab now, Grab is like Uber in the States, it sends you this text message. You got to fill out this little online health background check, you know, like a, you know, and it won't let the driver open the navigation until you submit that form. Kind of a headache. Good times. There's Fung squaring up, so they call the finger breakers off of me. Settling up my bill. Good times. Back to eating. Just coming here in a minute. So, also got, showed you this, guys, before, fresh basil. Gotta love it. Even the Vietnamese pho, sounds like pho, but it's pronounced pho. I mean, it looks like pho, P-H-O, like phone book, but it's pronounced pho. This is bunba, this is not pho, this is bunba ahoy, which is B-U-N space B-O space H-U-E, bunba hoy. And hoy is the place where it originally started. Hoy is a place in Vietnam. High five. I'm at Ho Chi Minh Airport domestic, and it's getting even more crazy. She's even got gloves on. So that one is there, and this family is right over here. They got like a, what do you call those? Beanie Babies? Is that ridiculous? So she's got the whole suit on, but she's taking her helmet off. Or she's taking her hat off right now while she's sitting. So my thoughts on the airport. That's proof that it is not cool in here. And humid and warm is perfect breeding grounds for any virus or bacteria. So the airport should have it nice and cold in here, but they don't. May 29th, Saturday, Memorial Weekend. Good times. All right, today is May 29th again, and we are inside the Hanoi International Airport, but we are on the domestic side of things. And it's hot, sweaty balls in here. The air conditioning barely works. And some fans. So it's a good time. And by gate A, there's hardly little or no air conditioning. But we are going today to Dalat, Vietnam. And we're going to be looking for a new house. So that ought to be fun. Why? Because I'm absolutely sick of Vinhomes Golden River. Don't let anybody tell you that lives at Vinhomes Golden River that it's so great, that it's so awesome. It's a place that's come way too far, way too long, been in business way too long on its name. It's gotten way too far, further than it should have gotten on its name. Horrible construction, horrible management. We have air conditioning that we cannot control. You've got thermostats, but I like to have my AC in a couple of other apartments I've had in Ho Chi Minh. I like to have my AC set at 21 degrees, and during the day, it'll barely get down. The lowest it ever gets down to is 23. Usually it's 25, 26 degrees. And what it came down to after 10 trips of their building engineers to my unit is that the it's not my units. We had them completely cleaned inside out, the filters, the condensers, everything. It turns out that it's the gas. You know, I was thinking it has to be the gas then. But in Vinhomes Golden River, you don't have your individual condensers that you can access. The building provides the cold air, or the cold water, cold gas, they call it. I think they call it cold water here, but it's the coolant. It's the building system, and it's just not cold enough. So they then sent out an email saying, oh, from the 18th to the 22nd, they're going to check everybody's units, or they're going to clean their system. We waited 2-3 days after the 22nd, and it was still no change at all in our unit. More recently, the biggest reason I'm leaving, just about a week ago, they did a false emergency announcement over the public announcement system that said there's an emergency in the building, leave now, evacuate the building, do not use elevators. And we took 47 something flights of stairs. So and on the way down on the 30th floor, we ran into complete darkness. It would have been another emergency if she didn't have her cell phone and was able to use that light for us. Also, when we got down to the towards the bottom on the 18th floor, an engineer was coming up saying, it's not an emergency, not an emergency. I saw an old lady out of breath, and I was just like, you know, they don't get it. I went all the way down because the alarm kept going off. It kept repeating that false alarm like 10, 15 times. I got it all on video. You'll see it soon. I've asked Vinhomes to refund my last 3 months of air conditioning. They never respond. I now told them I'm not going to pay my current charges or future charges until they fix it. But instead of all that, I'm just going to leave. It's just ridiculous. If you're a foreigner or a businessman or a local Vietnamese person,
thinking about moving to Venholm's Golden River, do not do it. Never. I've got an album on my phone with more than 80 photos of things that have gone wrong there over my last 9 months there. It's ridiculous. So we are breaking our contract under force majeure. If you sign a contract, make sure you have force majeure put in your contract. Force majeure means basically something that is outside of the unit owner's control. So like the air conditioning coolant, that's not his, that's the building's. Since they're not fixing it, I can break my contract, I can get my $50 million deposit back, and there's nothing they can do about it. So, also, do not sign a 2-year contract at all during these coronavirus times. And if you're smart, you won't even sign a 1-year contract. We found a lot of unit owners who are willing to take a 6-month contract and a 1-month deposit. Also, when we first moved to Venholm's Golden River, we were on the 40th floor. Our rent was $23 million for a 2-bedroom. We upgraded our unit. We did a 6-month contract, and at the end of that 6-month contract, which was about Christmas, the rents came down to $18 million. They went from $23 million to $18 million. It came down like 20-something%. That's because of COVID. So if your landlord's still getting rent that he was getting before COVID, you need to leave. Do not renew. Do not re-sign. There's plenty of landlords out there who are willing to negotiate. You just got to look around. There's landlords who will take 1-month deposit, not 2. There's some that we saw that will take no deposit. So, now, totally sick of it. That was just crazy. When I got down to the ground floor with that emergency going on, the front desk girls were laughing like, hee, hee, hee. I'm like, no, there's nothing funny. You know, take the smile off your face. You could cause someone a heart attack. A senior citizen coming down in the dark, like Fung's dad, who comes over to visit sometimes. He's on crutches. He just got getting over a broken hip. Someone like that could not make it down the stairs, and they'd be in trouble if they got to the dark spot and they couldn't hold the cell phone because they're holding their crutches. Venholm's management doesn't get that. I demanded the manager when I was there. I asked him to come back and we're going to walk around together. I walked him around, showed him the things, showed him a door that doesn't close. I've been reporting it for two weeks. You got to put your fingerprint. Don't need the fingerprint. You can just pull the doors open. They don't close all the way. So it's just kind of crazy. But they totally mismanaged, totally horrible place to live. I would never, ever live there again. You couldn't pay me to live there. So avoid Venholm's. The construction's horrible. The sinks. If you live in Venholm's, or you got a friend who lives there, try their bathroom sink. 90% you cannot close the drains because the lever underneath the sink hits the wood construction. They built them way too damn fast. We saw that construction even at Venholm's Central Park. Same exact issue with the bathroom sinks. So you need to just avoid all Venholm property. I'd avoid anything with Ben's name on it. Sorry, just he's not got the right management in place. And sooner or later, that name is going to be little or non-important at all. Now, on a positive note, I did hear that he just bought 40 million COVID vaccines. Who they're going to? I don't know. Are they going to go to the rich people first? Or is he going to sell them? Is he going to make 100 million on it? I don't know. But I'd be really interested in knowing where those COVID vaccines are going to go. So we'll see. Anyways, heading to Dalat, Vietnam, to check out where we are starting over. A new beginning in Dalat. I love it there. I've been there several times. Clean air, mountains, not too hot. Always a breeze. Love it. Check it out if you come to Vietnam. Back in a little bit. Absolutely gross. A freaking cockroach at the airport. Like the kind you don't want in your house. Fucking gross. I'm leaving on a jet plane. Don't know when I'll be back again. I see friends. I see Fong's underpants. Yeah. Ben, let's go. All right. It's Trent's first time. Hey, I was joking, Trin. We're taking a bus, not an airplane. Tell her it's a bus. Babe, tell her there's no airplane.
Nghĩ lại.
just driving out to the airplane. It's kind of sad to see all these parked trucks just not being used, like a whole parking lot full of runway trucks. So when you come to Vietnam, you'll see that Vietjet Airlines is, that's this yellow or red and yellow orange looking airplane over here. Hold on a second, filming for you. That's Vietjet. Their airline sucks. They cancel planes all the time. The first time I took one, someone told me, hey, don't do it because they delay and they cancel. And that's exactly what happens, and I ended up taking this one. Vietnam Airlines, and they are great. So, high five. Military planes on the runway, or on the tarmac, I should say. All right, this is going to be our whip. VN. Damn, Daniel. Oh man, that really pissed me off. In Vietnam, people tend to push you in public. They just don't give a shit. I will push back. Test me. This is going to be our flight. Our tail number, VN. 603. High five. What's up, yo? Where are we going, bro?
Place the mask over your nose.
Where are we going, bro?
Normally, while securing the elastic band around your neck.
Bro, where are we going? Secure, where are we going?
Should you assist children or fellow passengers?
The last, son? Yeah, son. Hey, yeah, okay, this is kind of important for you because your first time on a plane. You see that door over there? Well, listen, if there's emergency, our door is back there. Not that. There's a door there. You see it in the middle? You see it? There's a door over there, but we go that way. Hey, listen. If we land in the water, this one floats. You hold it in the water. If emergency, okay?
There are 8 exits,
and if you're gonna be this bag, okay? You don't know, bro. You don't know yet. You better keep it. You might need 2. You might need 2 barf bags. I've been trying to scare her all day.
Bro, you scared, bro?
Here we go.
Yeah, do like this, bro. Hands up, bro. Roller coaster. Train. Roller coaster, bro.
Oh, man. See, we're going through the clouds again. Now there's mountains. You see that? So now
It gets a little bouncy.
Yeah, bro.
Good times.
Tuesday?
Huh?
Tuesday, right?
Yeah. He said he hurt his shoulder.
How about Monday?
Monday he worked. Well, that's the day he was sleeping.
Mondays they work?
Yeah, see, we're on vacation, but we're doing payroll, so. Smile, babe. Smile. Smile, babe. With your mask on, smile. Babe, taking pictures. Babe. You don't be hitting on the airplane because they'll remove you when you go to jail. Okay, you don't go to jail. Jail. Crystal jail. Diamond in the sky, bro. Diamond in the sky.
Hey, look at that.
It's so
weird.
Beautiful.
It's so weird.
Hey, babe, I'm watching. I'm enjoying the flight, babe. No, no. Relax and enjoy the flight. Isn't it so beautiful green? Now see how clear the air is? No smoke. You see that? Babe, babe. Babe, you don't get like that. You don't get like that. I'll give you a kissy. Good job, man. That's the brakes, bro. Yeah, bro. What you freaking out about, bro? You're not scared. Oh, man. It might land in the water. Don't be scared, bro. Okay. Oh, that's the wing. The wing is falling off. Okay, that noise? That noise is the tires. The tires are going down. Landing gear. Oh, maybe not yet. No, that's just the flaps. The wings get longer. They come out. Welcome to the lot. Home of the famous YouTuber Angelo Canchola. Many other celebrities. Famous people. Has her secret garden here.
Chào quý khách, chào mừng quý khách đến với sân bay Liên Khương Đà Lạt. Bây giờ là 10 giờ 15 phút với nhiệt độ bên ngoài 24 độ C. Quý khách lưu ý vẫn ngồi yên tại chỗ, cài chặt dây an toàn cho đến khi máy bay dừng lại hẳn và đèn hiệu cài dây an toàn đã tắt. Cẩn thận khi mở ngăn hành lý, kiểm tra kỹ tư trang và tuyệt đối không mở cửa máy bay khi không có yêu cầu tiếp viên. Hành khách sử dụng dây an toàn cho em bé vui lòng để lại ghế ngồi hoặc gửi lại cho tiếp viên tại cửa máy bay.